of phrase or idiom. The first one is again and again, and its meaning is more than once. It means to do a thing repeatedly. Number two, now and then. It means from time to time. To and fro, it means backwards and forwards. Sooner or later mean at some time. And far and near mean in all directions, everywhere. So these were just phrases and their meanings. You have to use these phrases in these sentences. Hopefully after getting these meanings, you will be able to complete these statements. Number one, Akbar's fame spread. And the answer is far and near. Far and near mean Akbar's fame spread in all directions. Number two, the murderer will be caught sooner or later. Sooner or later, at some time, murderer will be caught. And here the solution of the rest of the exercise is also given, and you are supposed to attempt it on your book. Clear? Well, moving to the next page. Here, page number 21. Exercise C. With the help of a dictionary, try to find a synonym and an antonym. Synonym mean same meaning, and antonym mean opposite meaning. For each of the following words, write the synonym in the outer circle. Outer circle mean which is outside, and the antonym in the inner circle. One is done for you. I just have a look at this. This is the word given to you, brilliant. And brilliant here is the stupid. It means this is the antonym. You have to write down the antonym in the inner circle. This is the inner. And here is the intelligent. This is the synonym of brilliant. And you have to write down the synonym in the outer circle. Got it? So the next word is exciting. Exciting, its antonym is calm and its synonym is energetic. You may have the other options available to you or in the dictionary or on the Google. Okay, here the next the first word is wild, and its antonym is tame, and its I think tame is the antonym. Wild and tame, both are synonym. Tame will be written here, and here you can write peaceful. I'm going to repeat it for you because it's not written correct here. Wild, its antonym will be peaceful, and its synonym which you have to write in the outer column is tame. Clear, students? The next word is lovely. Its synonym is beautiful, and its antonym is hateful. And the last word is delicious. Its synonym is tasty, and its antonym is distasteful. Is it clear? Further, you can do your own research to complete this exercise. Well, exercise D, arrange the following words in alphabetical order. Alphabetical order means you have to write down these words in the order in which the alphabet is. If in alphabet A appears first, then you will write the word starting with A first. Let's suppose here admired is starting with A, so you will write it in the first. The next word is B. Yes, bravely. Here bravely, brilliant, bothered. Three words are starting with B, so just have a look at the second letter here. R, R, O. So we will write at number two, bothered. It's again starting with R, R, A, I. So A comes at first in alphabet. So this is number three, and this is number four. A, B, both are done. The next is C. Number five. In this way, you will complete the rest of the exercise. You are supposed to do this exercise on your notebooks and write them in alphabetical order. The next portion is about the grammar, and exercise A is, a number of sheep together is called a flock. What name is given to the following? Basically, this is about collective noun. Collective noun means a noun which represents a whole collection or group of anything, of a particular thing. Let's suppose a dash of cotton, and this is Luyan. I have written on a page. You can have look at it. A dash of cotton, and its answer is a bale of cotton. Number two, a dash of cattle, and its answer is a herd of cattle. Here, H-E-R-D, herd. Number three, a dash of musicians, and its answer is a band of musicians. Number four, a dash of thieves, and its answer is a gang of thieves. Number five, a dash of thread, and its answer is spool or yarn. Number six, a dash of kittens, and its answer is a litter of kittens. Number seven, a dash of stamps, and its answer is a collection of stamps. And number eight, and the last one, is a dash of flowers. It means a garland of flowers. And this is the solution. You may have a look at it. Well, now moving at page number 22. And here, exercise B, it's written, fill in the blanks with suitable word from the bubbles. They are all nouns. Here are the words in the bubbles, and nouns mean these all are naming words. You have to put a right noun in the correct blank. The first one is the guard blows his, and the answer is obviously a guard blows his whistle and waves his flag. Number two, the largest city in dash is dash. So the largest city in America is New York. Here the rest of the exercises is done for you. This is quite easy, and you can do it by your own self or with a little help from your parents. You can complete this exercise. Well, next exercise is, put all the words you have filled in the blanks under the right column. One is done for you. Here again, two columns are for you, common nouns and proper nouns. Hopefully you will be aware about common and proper, but I'm going to re-explain it for you. Here I'm going to re-explain it for you. Common nouns mean a noun which is common, which can be the name of many persons or many things. And here is a proper noun. Proper noun mean which is a unique name and which is always written in capital. So here I have put these words, or the words which are given in bubbles, in the correct column. The first one was kittens. So kitten is a common noun, and it is written in lower case, so it is a common noun. The next is chickens. Chickens is also a common noun. And the third one is New York, which is written in capital. So this is a particular or special or proper noun, and it will be written in this column, New York. In this way, you will complete this exercise. And the next page and the last page is page number 23, not last. Here it is written, the teacher will read out a paragraph, listen to it carefully, and group the common and proper nouns. Well, this paragraph is given at page number 129 with the unit number and the title of the unit. So you can read this page from page number 129. I may open this page for you. Here, this paragraph is available for you. After having the reading of this paragraph, you will be able to complete this exercise, whoever the solution is given for you. Here, the common nouns given in at that paragraph are sorted out in this column, and all the proper nouns are written down in this column. So you are not supposed to do these two activities. Next, and now, the last page is page number 24. Here is an activity for you. Are you a girlfriend? What makes you a good friend? In the picture given below, write the qualities of a good friend. One is done for you, and that quality is written loyalty. Next, I have note on the other qualities: faithful, loving, caring, trustworthy. You may have your own qualities which you have in your friends. So you are supposed to do this exercise at page number 24. So this is the end of the lecture. Hopefully it will be helpful in your studies. Thank you. Have a good time.